Optimize your thinking. How to unlock your performance potential. As a thinker, capitalize on strengths and overcome any thought patterns undermining your success. As a team member, gain influence and master the art of interpersonal dynamics. As a leader, position your team for improved morale and maximum productivity. By Jennifer Witt, PMP and Certified Performance Coach. A conclusion to optimize your thinking. As we begin the groundwork discussed in this chapter, it's important to know your roles. As you learned in the Optimize Your Thinking book, your performance potential depends on your effectiveness in three distinct life roles: how you perform as a thinker, a team member, a leader. Even if you're a remarkable leader, you must also possess the ability to be led. We are all members of a team, whether it's a family, a community, or a company. In this chapter, we will answer the following questions.
As a thinker, can you break the narrow thought patterns holding you back? As a team member, are you able to understand others who think differently from you? As a leader, can you reposition a group to reach new levels of performance? When under stress, can you evaluate a situation from multiple perspectives? If you're like most people, you default to only a few ways of thinking, maybe even less. The more intense the pressure, the more likely we are to resort to fewer ways of thinking, which results in a limited perspective that can be debilitating and sometimes damaging. But with a multifaceted worldview, utilizing the 8 ways of thinking, you can unravel the stress and uncover new opportunities for progress. To truly optimize your thinking, you'll want to not only master the 8 ways of thinking during good times, but also exercise your new thinking skills whenever the situation calls for it. As a thinker, can you break the narrow thought patterns holding you back? As a team member, are you able to understand others who think differently from you? As a leader, can you reposition a group to reach new levels of performance? You now know there are at least 8 sides to every story. Fortunately, it only takes one person willing to apply many-sided thought to accomplish great things.
The following story will help you better understand how real-life situations can challenge you to optimize your thinking.
As Dr. Disaster stepped down from the stage, he felt like he was walking into a firing squad. He could only imagine the outrage his unexpected appearance had ignited. But the truth was, he had no other options. The MC he'd secured had been highly recommended to him by someone he respected. Dr. Disaster always suspected the worst of strangers, but the fellow had managed to win even him over. It wasn't until the MC canceled by leaving a voice message the day of the event that Dr. Disaster realized he should have worked with a talent agency instead of going with one person's recommendation. With no time to spare, he had even driven around to approach several agencies in person, but his efforts were futile as everyone was booked. "I had no other choice," he told the team as they huddled around him to listen to his explanation. "No other choice," Donna the detective repeated, not concealing the aggravation in her voice. "You could have gotten us involved," Fireman Fred said, gesturing to the team members with both hands. Dr. Disaster heard several murmurs of agreement. "Now, let's give our attention to these amazing dancers," Stacy announced after Harry finished his short explanation of the cause. Stacy's voice penetrated the argumentative circle of the team, and they awakened to the fact that they were at an event that they had worked extremely hard to put together. "Shirley, Frank, show them how it's done." Stacy signaled to two dancers who stood next to the stage. The couple immediately walked to the center of the dance floor. Wearing a neatly pressed zoot suit with white and black spectator shoes, the male dancer nodded to cue the band and extended his hand to his dance partner. She grasped it, and the duo jumped to energetic tune. The other two couples from the Swing Dance Society soon joined them, each taking turns in the middle of the dance floor. The audience gasped as the women were tossed by their partners. Some even went airborne. With dramatic lifts and aerial moves, the dancers captivated the guests. Now let's get some audience members in this competition. Stacy called into the microphone. Dr. Disaster, how about you give your honored guest, the mayor, a little spin? To Stacy's disappointment, Dr. Disaster scurried to the restroom before Stacy could embarrass him further. Miss Jones, can we see that jitterbug? She asked the leader, who only laughed in response. Come on, team, get the party started, Stacy finally pleaded to her team members. Harry felt responsible for putting Stacy on the spot, so he came down from the stage, placed his arm around Nurse Nancy's shoulders, and asked her to join him. Ivan the inventor soon followed, as did many of the guests. Stacy watched with pleasure as the mayor danced, not with Dr. Disaster, but with one of the professional dancers. For everyone, the night sped by in a hectic blur, with the guests dining and dancing until after midnight. The pledges for the park amounted to almost $72,000, far beyond the $50,000 goal. As guests lingered around the new swing set, a spirit of wistfulness descended, and the evening drew to a close. Nurse Nancy took time to hug her volunteers as they left, and with a sense of sadness and relief, the event was over. The team parted ways to go home. At 8 a.m. on Monday morning, the team gathered in the East Conference Room as scheduled. To everyone, it was very clear who would win the trip and who would not. Each member felt gratitude towards Stacy for her successful stint as MC, and much of the animosity toward Dr. Disaster still remained after two nights' sleep. Mrs. Jones also expected Stacy to win, and she was relieved the choice would not cause debate. She entered a room filled with happy chatter. Please vote for the person you think should win by writing her, his name on a sheet of paper in front of you. Remember, this is anonymous, she instructed the team. Silence followed, and with formality, the team members placed their folded ballots in front of Mrs. Jones. Once all had voted, Mrs. Jones proceeded to read each aloud. We have a vote for Stacy, another one for Swinging Stacy. Ivan the inventor smiled to hear his own vote. Stacy winked at him. Stacy, yes, Stacy, Mrs. Jones continued. I think we have our winner, Mrs. Jones announced as she opened the last vote. Wait, Dr. Disaster? Mrs. Jones read the last vote aloud, unable to hide her disbelief. While Stacy clearly won the overall vote, Dr. Disaster was the last name she expected to see on the ballot. What? Dr. Disaster was equally shocked to hear his name come up. You've got to be kidding me, Fireman Fred stated with visible disgust, still angry with Dr. Disaster for trying to handle the crisis on his own. The dissension of the room grew as the team members disputed the meaning of this unexpected vote. Wait a second, Donna the detective called over the chatter. Majority wins, right, Mrs. Jones? Mrs. Jones nodded and opened her mouth to speak, but Stacy interrupted her. Not so fast, guys. I have a confession, Stacy said, rising from her seat. The talking ceased, and all eyes turned to Stacy. She felt uncharacteristically shy as she told the team she could not accept their nomination. Believe me, I'd love a trip to Mexico, but I can't possibly go, she explained. But why? Donna demanded. Everyone watched Stacy with stunned expectancy. Well, you see, I'm the reason there was no MC. I convinced Dr. Disaster to use my friend, and he did. Oh dear, Nurse Nancy said, sitting back in her seat. The heat of debate surrounded the team. Dr. Disaster tried to take back ownership of the MC decision, but the team wouldn't hear him. You were protecting Stacy at the expense of the team, Fireman Fred insisted. No, I was not, Fred. Stacy delivered the dancers and the band. Believe me, if there was anything that could be done, I would have done it, Dr. Disaster shot back with anger. People, Susie Sunshine yelled in an attempt to get the team's attention. They all ignored her until she said, I'd like to place another vote. Let's hear it, Ivan the inventor responded, still hoping he might have a chance. I'd like to vote for I've Got a Hunch Harry. Again, debate erupted. Now hear me out, Susie raised her voice. What was the most important part of this task? Why were we all here? she challenged. To win, Fireman Fred volunteered. To raise money for the park, Nurse Nancy corrected him. Exactly, Susie exclaimed. Harry came up with the sponsorship idea, helped raise the funds we really needed, balanced this complex budget, and stood up for his beliefs. He's why we're successful. Susie's passion was persuasive. I have to say I agree, Mrs. Jones commented. But again, it's your decision. A strained hush descended. Several team members still felt bitter about Harry's budget dispersion, but no one dared voice it in Mrs. Jones' presence. I say we have another vote, Nurse Nancy suggested. The silent room indicated the teammates agreed, though not happily. Several minutes later, a second vote revealed a divided team. Harry got 3 votes. Fireman Fred received 1, as did Donna the detective, Nurse Nancy, Susie Sunshine, and Ivan the inventor. Well, we do have a winner. Congratulations, Harry, Mrs. Jones announced. I also need to wrap up this meeting as I have another one at 9. I do, however, want to thank each of you for your hard work. I will inform your managers of your success. She held up her hand to quiet the team when the debate threatened to continue. The vote is over, she warned. With that, Mrs. Jones left for her next meeting. Harry stayed in his seat and watched the team members depart. He received a few pats on the back, but a black mood lingered in the room with him. Harry felt undeserving and upset. To him, Stacy still deserved the trip, or Dr. Disaster, who was willing to be an MC, or Susie, who had to fight a team who doubted her. In fact, Harry could find a reason for everyone to win the trip instead of him. This just doesn't feel right, he repeated to himself over and over. After racking his brain, Harry came up with a plan. He later met with Mrs. Jones, who appreciated his idea and quickly sent an email to the team. Your generous team member, Harry, wishes that you all share in his reward. He has asked that we use the money set aside for this trip to treat you all and your significant others to a 5-star dinner. Stay tuned for more details. Signed, Mrs. Jones. Regarding the email, Harry instantly felt relieved as the thank you notes trickled in throughout the day. Harry knew he had done the right thing by following his instincts. It just felt wrong. Mexico would have been nice, but who would want to come home to enemies? He told Stir It Up Stacy later that afternoon in the Miniview Corporation lobby as they were leaving for the day. Oh, we're all sore losers, Harry. We would have gotten over it, she said with a laugh. But I'm looking forward to that big steak, she teased. Too much cholesterol, the voice of Dr. Disaster interrupted. Harry and Stacy quickly turned their heads to see Dr. Disaster hurrying by with a smirk. Not so fast, Doc, Stacy warned. You owe me a dance, she called, rushing after his retreating figure. As Harry walked to his car, he noticed the new swing set sparkling against the backdrop of the gloomy park across the street. 2 children were inspecting it with obvious glee. Harry imagined the park as it would be after the work was completed, groomed and abloom with flowers around an elegant fountain. Now that feels right, Harry said wistfully to the passing breeze. Achieve. How to optimize your thinking. Countless philosophers have arrived at the same conclusion. Success is a state of mind. How you view the world directly impacts your effectiveness in it. What you see is, in fact, what you get. Let's take a moment to look at each character. Ivan the Inventor. Perhaps you view life like Ivan the Inventor. You see numerous possibilities. Unleashing your imagination to solve a problem is easy for you. It's reeling it back in that can pose a challenge. Donna the Detective. You may conclude that you apply Donna the Detective's way of thinking. You prefer to look at life through the lens of logic. Her brain is a finely tuned muscle that she's not afraid to use to dissect a problem. It's important, however, to turn off the inner analyst when the occasion calls for it. Dr. Disaster. If you choose to see the world through Dr. Disaster's eyes, you live in a danger-laden place. Ironically, you are also quite safe, as you're constantly looking out for what could and sometimes will go wrong. Stir It Up Stacy. If you resemble Stir It Up Stacy's thinking style, then you view each environment as a place for change. You've probably experienced much success, but you've also found yourself in trouble for breaking rules that exist for a reason. I've got a hunch, Harry. And there are the intuitive thinkers out there, like I've got a hunch, Harry, who view the world through instinct. If you gravitate towards this thinking style, you possess a golden key to understanding the world. Unfortunately, this key is not easily understood or recognized by the world, and you may also be guilty of discounting the knowing feelings in your gut. Nurse Nancy. Or, like Nurse Nancy, you may see the world only as it relates to people. To you, success is equivalent to an abundance of healthy relationships. Using eagerness and kindness, you may give of yourself to everyone, except perhaps yourself. Susie Sunshine. Those of you like Susie Sunshine create fortune by visualizing it. You can't deny the bright side of life, which draws others to you, but occasionally you might find that your optimism borders on being naive. Fireman Fred. If you take life by the bullhorns, then you are accustomed to Fireman Fred's results-oriented thinking style. You see life as a series of problems, and you set out to fix them, but contemplation needs to happen in between. All of these characters mentioned are set in their ways, but you are not. Remember, each character represents a single way of thinking, whereas individuals can possess unlimited combinations of each thinking style. The cast members of the Octagon simply embody the traits of a thinking style. By no means do they define a person. You may lean toward one way of thinking or many. If you feel you're able to easily practice all 8 ways of thinking, then you have achieved what most people cannot in a lifetime. More often, people have dominant thinking styles that they resort to out of comfort, especially during stressful times. But how you think is a choice. Minds can change, perspectives can shift, eyes can open. With a thoughtful approach, you can enhance your mode of thinking to encompass all perspectives or sides of a story. You now have this manual for each way of thinking. It's up to you to use it. And here's how. Stop to think about your thinking. How many times have you caught yourself wondering where the time went? All of a sudden, it's another year. In the bustle of modern living, you might feel you must keep up with the pace dictated by society. When you accomplish something, you always set your sights on the next goal, then the next. When times are tough, you might focus on how to fix problems, not on why they happened, or the lessons that can be learned as a result. Although we don't emphasize these activities as a society, self-reflection and introspection are some of the most empowering ways we can spend our time. Are you taking the time? If not, abandon the excuses and take 20 minutes each day to think about your interactions with others, how you felt during the day, and what motivated you to make the decisions you did. You may choose to take a refreshing stroll during this time. Avoid being critical or passing judgment. Instead, be an objective observer of yourself. You now know the ways of thinking. Which did you use during the day? Did you fall prey to any common weaknesses? A few minutes of self-reflection can lead to years of success. You are truly your best lesson if you're willing to learn from yourself. Apply the 8 ways of thinking. Now that you've taken the time to contemplate the day's challenges and how you tackled them, you can apply your insight from the 8 ways of thinking. How would the inventive thinker have solved that problem? The analytical thinker. Which way of thinking would have been most effective for dismantling the stress? You will find this exercise especially easy to do when thinking about specific situations you struggle through. Hindsight always provides perspective to see what you could have done differently. A great benefit can also come from acknowledging what you did right, which ways of thinking worked for you, and why. Don't overlook the ways of thinking that will work for you. Rather, you can enhance your dominant thinking styles to become all the more effective. Your natural tendency to be an assertive thinker or a pessimistic thinker can be polished by cultivating the strengths of each way of thinking. Identify common weaknesses. There is no perfect human being. We all know people who delude themselves into thinking they are beyond fault. Then there are those who feel like they can never be good enough. They strive for perfection, which inevitably eludes them. But it's those who admit their faults with a sense of humor that are primed for success. These individuals are humbled by life and empowered by humility. They don't think they know best. They know they can only do their best. For instance, Nurse Nancy was accustomed to being the go-to person for everyone's problems, whether in her neighborhood, at her daughter's school, or at work. She enjoyed looking out for those around her and found that her job in human resources was well-suited for her strengths. However, when tasked with managing the volunteers for the high-profile charity event, she knew she had to reassess her altruistic way of thinking. She recognized that her giving nature was allowing others to take advantage of her. Before it was too late, she took the time to call every volunteer to ensure they understood the expectations she had for them. While someone like Fireman Fred or Donna the detective may have been more emotionally economical in their methods with the volunteers, Nurse Nancy did it the best way she knew how, and her best was a success. Learn from setbacks. If you are listening now, then you are already establishing yourself as a person who wishes to grow and improve, to learn from others, yourself, and life. This willingness to change is power. It can grow with you throughout the years, no matter what birthday you're celebrating. The enlightened old man is the one who looks at the world with childlike eyes. He's still learning, still discovering, and failing on occasion. If you fail, at least it means you tried, and trying is truly living. If a situation does not go as planned, or if you find yourself saddled with regret, you can ask yourself a single question that, if answered affirmatively, can counter those negative feelings. Did I do my best? If your answer is yes, if you know in your innermost self that you tried heartily, then you know you sought to reach your performance potential. You can be satisfied with yourself. If your best was not successful at that point in time, then you can recognize that you were not meant to succeed at that task, but to learn from it. This is by no means an excuse. It's self-forgiveness, which is another form of success. Forgive others' failures. Conflict with others is a central cause of discord and a human obstacle to realizing potential in many people's lives. We spend much of our time arguing with, debating, or resenting those around us. Whether it's your coworker or your best friend, the person that upsets you the most may very often be a person who's closest to you. We can look at the mistakes of others from afar and forgive relatively easily. Politicians cheating on their wives, celebrities getting DUIs. We see bad things happen, but we do not hold grudges for long. It's the personal offense that stays with us. He lied to me. She forgot about me. If you take me out of the equation for a moment, you can understand that it's not about you at all. The people around you travel the same difficult road of life with their own unique challenges. It's rare a person who truly wishes to ignite your anger who intends to hurt you. Your potential is intrinsically tied to how well you treat people around you. To fail to forgive is your own failure. Even if people do not ask for your forgiveness, it is yours to give. Set yourself free by handing out forgiveness wherever you can. Use the 8 ways of thinking to view a situation from different perspectives. You don't have to condone other people's actions to forgive. If you alter your perspective, you will discover that most people are going about life the best way they know how. Aim higher. Have you ever felt that you lived an entire life in a single day? Perhaps it was a special occasion, like your wedding. Maybe you had an epiphany and found forgiveness you'd been lacking. Sometimes just the sun shining can awaken a new spirit in you. Now that you know the eight ways of thinking, every day has its own potential for growth. You awake in the morning disposed to a certain way of thinking. You feel resolute, perhaps, and so you gather the courage to ask for a raise. Later, you harness the optimistic style so you invest in that stock you've been eyeing. Dinner time lends itself to inventive thinking, where you experiment by adding new ingredients to a tired recipe. That night, you try on altruistic thinking as you listen empathetically to your wife recount her difficult day at work. Just imagine the full life you could live if you used all eight ways in a single day. You've met the cast of the Optagon, and you know their strengths and weaknesses and what situations they're best suited for. Reaching your performance potential is dependent upon your ability to embrace these ways of thinking throughout the course of a day. For instance, what are you getting ready to do as soon as you set down this book? Which way or ways of thinking would position you for success in that situation? Just the act of contemplating the eight ways of thinking will bring you to a higher level of achievement. Over time, you will find you automatically consider your course of action in context with the Optagon. As you become a more experienced, many-sided thinker, you will find your personal or dominant style naturally encompasses all eight ways of thinking in every situation. For example, I've got a hunch Harry did not feel at ease about winning the trip. By applying all eight ways of thinking, he was able to see how every individual contributed and deserved a piece of the prize. The ways of thinking also empowered him to resolve an extremely complex situation. Harry's dominant way of thinking, the intuitive style, alerted him to the unfairness of the situation. Pessimistic thinking told him that he would return from the trip to grudging co-workers. Optimistic thinking helped him realize the situation still had hope. It could be improved upon. With assertive thinking, he challenged the rule that indicated he had to go on the trip. Through analytical thinking, he evaluated the situation and decided to solve the dilemma by dividing the prize among his team. Using inventive thinking, he came up with a unique alternative for his reward, a shared dinner. Altruistic thinking gave him the courage to follow through on his selfless proposition. With resolute thinking, he took action, approaching Mrs. Jones right away. How many people would act the same in this situation? If your answer is a pessimistic not many, you're probably right. Most would brush aside their feelings of unfairness and go on the trip. Some might take the guilt with them on the trip. Perhaps a few would try to return the prize, but without offering an alternative plan. If one person got as far as offering a plan, could he come up with the dinner idea? And who would not hesitate before they acted, possibly letting the window of opportunity slip by? In this single situation, you can see how the eight ways of thinking, when aptly applied, can lead to higher peaks of performance. It's an extraordinary individual who strives to acquire the strengths of all ways of thinking. It's a successful individual who actually does. Influence. How to optimize your relationships. As you unlock your performance potential, the significance of your relationships will become more and more evident. You'll soon find that effective thinking requires a nurturing environment of family members, colleagues, and friends. Similarly, success depends on your ability to influence those around you. The power of each thought is multiplied by your ability to share it with others. You understand how complex you are as an individual. For successful relationships, you must adapt your thinking to the complexities of many. The eight ways of thinking can serve as your roadmap to navigating the thinking styles of people around you. But again, the eight ways of thinking do not define human beings. If you recognize your boss as Donna the detective, you may realize she also exhibits the strengths of Nurse Nancy or others. You can best utilize the eight ways of thinking by first knowing yourself and applying the various perspectives. Once you've identified your own thinking patterns, you can take the next step. improving how you relate to those around you. Observe your interactions. As you speak with friends, family, and coworkers throughout the day, look for clues that reveal their ways of thinking. Your sister may seem to resemble Dr. Disaster, continually grumbling about her car problems. Your coworker may remind you of Ivan the Inventor as he sketches his dream home for you. Be wary of jumping to any initial conclusions. What you observe in a single day may not be indicative of a person's dominant style. We can all behave like Dr. Disaster on occasion. As you recognize the Optagon's characters and those around you, be delicate when sharing your observations. Some people will not appreciate hearing that you've labeled them unless you explain the overall 8 ways of thinking concept. Identify dominant styles. Once you've interacted with your boss or spouse with the 8 ways of thinking in mind, you may feel comfortable identifying his or her dominant style. Perhaps your best friend seems like stirred-up Stacy during certain situations. For example, he always raises his hand at the neighborhood association meetings to confront an issue or a person. But you notice that he leaves the meeting participants in a state of agitation. He only stirs things up. Offer constructive feedback. In the scenario just described, you can help your friend become more successful by encouraging him to balance his approach. Usually, what is termed a weakness is simply an overutilized strength. A way of thinking can lend itself to varying traits, depending on which way the scale is tipped. By first acknowledging a person's strength, you will find him more receptive to hearing about his overutilized strength or weakness. In the case of the friend, you can tell him you respect his desire to raise relevant issues by saying what others are afraid to say, but also challenge him to consider whether or not he got the result he wanted. If not, encourage him to make his assertive way of thinking more effective by presenting his thoughts in a less accusatory manner. You can help him understand that with a balanced approach, his way of thinking can truly work for him. Alter your own thinking. In some cases, you may find that your friend or loved one does not wish to hear how they could be more effective. Or if your relationship is less intimate, like with that of your boss, it may not be appropriate to offer personal advice. Your ability to identify the person's thinking style remains an empowering exercise, even in these cases. With your ways of thinking insight, you can change your own thinking to enhance the relationship. For instance, you may realize that your coworker often adopts the thinking style of Fireman Fred. She runs around trying to solve one problem after another, never stopping to see if the problems can solve themselves. You may initially find that you get caught up in her race for results. However, after recognizing it's her way of thinking that contributes to the frantic pace, you can remove yourself from any unnecessary drama. Improve your communication. With a firm grasp of the 8 ways of thinking, you can better influence others and in turn successfully sell your ideas. To influence a person, it helps to be fundamentally aware of what motivates him or her to act. When you know a person's dominant way of thinking, you can frame your ideas in the context of how he or she thinks. Consider each way of thinking and the core motivation. For example, if you've led volunteers for a charity event, you know that sustaining volunteer motivation can be a challenge. In order to motivate the characters to give their best thinking to the Miniview Corporation charity event, Mrs. Jones used the competition for a trip. But what if she didn't have a trip to offer? Using the 8 ways of thinking, she could motivate each character according to his or her style of thought. Let's consider each character and what motivates them. Ivan the Inventor. Ivan the Inventor can be motivated by hearing how the charity event offers an excellent opportunity to extend his imagination, whether by creating the theme or with other creative tasks, such as the event's decor. Donna the Detective reacts to the reason in an idea. If she sees the event as an exercise in logistics, she will be instantly engaged, sometimes to the point of not sleeping at night. Dr. Disaster. To motivate Dr. Disaster, he needs to be assured that the event idea is bulletproof. Dr. Disaster also responds to an appreciation of his best asset, his foresight for failure. Stir It Up Stacy. Stir It Up Stacy's passion is fueled by an opportunity for change. If encouraged to create a sense of urgency for the event, as through public relations, she's quickly on board. I've Got a Hunch Harry. I've Got a Hunch Harry relies on his feelings to determine his level of excitement. Asking him to remember past charity work that was a success can spawn the good feelings he needs to commit. Nurse Nancy. Nurse Nancy cares about the other people involved in the event. If Nancy hears that the event is an opportunity to enhance her relationships, she will give her all. Susie Sunshine. Susie Sunshine is motivated by the ideal scenario. Painting a picture of a magical event and a beautiful park will make Susie a champion for the cause. Fireman Fred. Fireman Fred needs to see the results that can be achieved. If asked to focus on immediate challenges, the event will automatically reside at the forefront of his mind. Throughout this simple example, you can get an idea of how a keen understanding of each way of thinking can arm you with the powers of persuasion. As you learn to position your thoughts and ideas for each individual thinker, you will see influence grow, not only within your relationships, but also within teams and your community. Lead. How to optimize your team. Groups are as individual as people. Two groups of thinkers can tackle the same problem and devise drastically different solutions. It's the chemistry or thinking combination that determines how a group behaves collectively. When in charge of a group, you might have the opportunity to decide who will comprise your team. If this is the case, you will no doubt try to choose individuals who demonstrate signs of empowered thinking. They know how to maximize their strengths and minimize weaknesses. Don't forget that there's room for Dr. Disaster on any team. While he may bring a cloud of negativity, through strategic leadership, you can help him harness his foresight for failure to benefit the team. More often than not, however, you will be assigned a predefined group to lead. For instance, you do not get to choose the members of your family or the neighbors in your homeowners association. As a leader, you will be forced to work with people at all stages of potential, some who have realized it, some who have not, and maybe a few who have abandoned their potential altogether. Your job as a leader is to guide each team member to his or her ultimate potential so the group can succeed together. Determine your team's ways of thinking. If you're charged with leading a team to accomplish a task, you'll want to take the time to learn about their individual ways of thinking. Meet with each team member to discuss the task at hand. Sometimes you'll find it's not the answers that tell you the most. Instead, it's the questions they ask that reveal a dominant way of thinking. For example, Ivan the Inventor might pose the challenge, "What's a different way to do this?" Donna the Detective might ask, "What are all the facts?" Dr. Disaster often can't help saying, "What is the worst possible outcome?" Stir It Up Stacy might wonder, "Is there a way to liven things up?" I've Got a Hunch Harry will ask himself, "What feels right and wrong about this situation?" Nurse Nancy usually wants to know, "Who is the most upset?" Susie Sunshine will probably ask, "What's the best possible outcome?" Fireman Fred typically cares most about one thing. What's at the center of the problem? Share the 8 ways of thinking with your team members and ask them to tell you which characters they relate to the most. Always encourage multifaceted thought, but also emphasize that each member brings an original style and skill set to the team. While self-analysis is a good indicator of how a person thinks, you may find that someone who calls himself an analytical thinker, like Donna the Detective, also thinks like Dr. Disaster during times of stress. As a leader, you will have to recognize each team member's strengths and weaknesses. In fact, your effectiveness as a leader often depends on your ability to make these distinctions. However, there are times where you will not have the luxury of getting to know your team members, and you might find it productive to allow them to choose tasks for themselves. Mrs. Jones, the MiniView Corporation CEO, asked her team members to choose roles because she did not know their styles, nor did she have the opportunity to learn more about each individual. Assign roles based on style. After observing and evaluating your team, you can apply your insight of the 8 ways of thinking to help them thrive in those tasks that leverage their ways of thinking. The ideal roles might be obvious. For example, you'll want to put Nurse Nancy in a people-based role, such as human resources, customer service, or account management. Ivan the Inventor thrives in creative roles, like marketing and advertising. However, sometimes the choices that seem obvious introduce new complexities you don't expect. As the results-oriented problem solver, Fireman Fred appeared to be the best candidate for executing the charity event. However, his insistence that every problem be addressed immediately introduced an anxiety that was bad for the team's morale and obvious to the guest. In hindsight, Mrs. Jones would know how to caution Fireman Fred to conceal his alarm from others when possible. Remember, every strength, when carried to an extreme, can become a weakness. Donna can overanalyze. Dr. Disaster can introduce a state of dread. Stacy can break too many rules. Harry can be emotionally biased. Ivan the Inventor can blow the budget with reinvention. Nancy can overconcern herself with others' issues. Susie can overlook obvious risk. Fireman Fred can step on the toes of others. By assigning suitable roles and advising your team to keep their strengths in check, you can build a team that's primed for success. Utilize strengths according to the situation. You now know that each way of thinking introduces unique strengths that make a thinker especially suited for a specific role. A thinker's strengths can also be applied to a number of situations. No matter her role or position, Susie Sunshine can help build team morale. When you discover your team spirit is low, you'll want to utilize her strength in this area. Quite often, however, leaders unwittingly turn to a single person before all others. A certain team member may naturally become your go-to person over time. For instance, you may find that an assertive thinker like Stirred Up Stacy is always willing to help. So when something needs to be done, you ask Stacy. Other team members may bitterly observe this, feeling you found the favorite, while knowing they're more qualified for specific tasks. Leaders often overlook that this reliance on a single person places an unfair burden on that person while disgruntling the entire team. Instead, try to distribute responsibility evenly according to individual strengths for the specific situation. Leveraging your knowledge of the 8 ways of thinking, you can determine which thinker to deploy in various situations. Use the 8 ways of thinking and each scenario to guide you through these difficult decisions. Every person has at least one dominant way of thinking. If you can identify the dominant styles of your team members, you can position them for success. Some thinkers may have several dominant ways of thinking, so they're highly effective in more situations. We can all master the 8 ways of thinking in order to advance our performance in our own lives, jobs, families, and communities, but the path is unique for each individual. Some ways of thinking will come easily to you. Others will require steady practice over a period of time. When facing any challenge, you must be willing to possibly fail in order to succeed. However, your continuous efforts will undoubtedly pay off. And once you unlock your performance potential, you can give life your best thinking and enjoy the success this brings. As a certified performance coach, I have learned that you are your most important project. I invite you now to journal your thinking and discover the success keys you already possess to unlock your own performance potential. Reference optimizeyourthinking.com to learn more about our learning systems, certifications, and licensing programs.
So, are you ready to conquer the world with the 8 ways of thinking? Not just yet. You've looked at each thinking style individually. Now, with the following exercises, examine your thought processes holistically with all 8 ways of thinking in mind. At this time, please reference your thinking journal.
Thank you for participating in our self-paced courses on PDUs2Go.com. Now that you've finished listening to this recorded session, please be sure to complete all written exercises in your course guide. When completed, you have met the requirements to register your PDUs with PMI. Clear instructions to do so are available in your course guide. PDUs2Go.com is powered by Optimo Incorporated, a global registered education provider with PMI. Be sure to explore more courses on our site, as many project managers consider us the iTunes for project managers. We look forward to helping you earn more PDUs through self-paced courses that allow you to learn and earn PDUs that's portable and affordable. Be sure to tell a colleague or friend to visit us at PDUs2Go.com. And thank you.